Hello all. We started a brief study of the society that prevailed during the reign of King Ilanthiraiyan. We stopped by and learned a little about a section of people who lived on the mountains. We shall continue with the poem. Palai nila kaanavargalin vettai maanadi poritha mayangu adir marangin vaanmadi puludil neernasai kulitha agal sool payambin agathu olithu odungi புகழாவாகை பூவின் அன்ன வளைமறுப்பு ஏனம் வரவு பார்த்திருக்கும் அரை நாள் வேட்டம் அழுங்கின் பகல் நாள் பகுவாய் நியமலியோடு பைன் புதல் எருக்கி தொகுவாய் வேலி தொடர் வலை மாட்டி முள்ளரை தாமரை புல் இதழ் புறையும் நெடுஞ்செவி குறுமுயல் பூக்கு அறவழையி கடுங்கன் கானவர் கடறு கூட்டுண்ணும் Arunjuram iranda ambar. Huntsmen of the deserts. At dusk when stag hoof prints seen, water holes dug when rains failed, forgotten to be clothes that serve as hide spots, among golden flowers of humming tree, waiting for the curved horned wild pig, hunt ceased at midnight, the other half fanged mouths of the hunting dogs search around the bushes, where nets laid mid of high fences, like the petals of thorny lilies, long-eared wild hares not let escape, wild and tough tribes feast upon together, pass the wild desert to travel further. The poet says that the next set of tribe would be huntsmen of the deserts. These were natives of lands where it never rained. The people used to dig water holes to store rainwater which dried up during the summer. These water holes were used as hiding spots by hunters. These hunters hid themselves waiting for wild stags or wild pigs that roamed in search of water. Sometimes these hunters used their hunting dog to search among thick bushes that had burrows of wild hares. The hunters wore fine nets that were tied between bushes and shrubs. These nets help them to catch small animals. The poet says that the tribe always feasted together and the troop would be welcome to join them. He says that in order to travel further, the troop will have to pass through that wild desert. Eenaradu aranil perum porutkal parundu pada onna thevvar nadunga ochi vainudi mulungiya pulavu vaayekam vadimani palagaiyodu niraiye mudinaan சாபம் சாத்திய கனை துஞ்சுவியல் நகர் ஊகம் வேத உயர்நிலை வரைப்பின் வரைத்தேன் புறையும் கவை கடை புதையோடு கடுந்துடி தூங்கும் கணைக்கார் பந்தர் தொடர்நாயாத்த துன்னுரங்கடி நகர் வாழ் முள் வேலி சூழ் மிளைப்படப்பை கொடுநுகம் தழிய புதவின் செந்நிலை நெடுநுதி வயக்கழு நிறைத்த வாயில் கொடுவில் ஈயின குறும்பில் சேப்பின் களர் வளர் ஈந்தின் கால் கண்டன்ன சுவள் விளை நெல்லின் செவ் அவிழ் சோன்றி ஞமலி தந்த மனவ சூழ் உடும்பின் வரைக்கால் யாதத்து வயந்தோறும் பெருகுவீர் கிஃப்ட்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த ஃபாரஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி ஆரோ மேக்கர்ஸ் டெரிஃபைங் அட்டாக் ஆன் ஃபோர்ஸ் தட் இன்வைட்ஸ் ஸ்கேவெஞ்சர் ஹாக்ஸ் பஞ்சன்ட் மீட்டி ஸ்மெல் ஆன் த ஷார்ப் அண்ட் டிப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்பியர்ஸ் Broad shields decorated with beads aligned, bow and arrow tied at the wide hut entrances. Monkey grass used to thatch the high fences. Shrimped combs tied to the tails of arrows. Palm drums tied to the thick posts of the tents. Tightly secured huts with ferocious hounds on guard. Greeny thorns used as fences. Bulky crossbars guarding the front doors. Sturdy, sharp, spear-headed logs as weapons too. The bowed bows expertly crafted by the tribes. From the farms on plateau harvested red rice. From fennel-like paddy cooked to perfection. Monitors hunted by hounds with eggs shaped like conches cooked and served will you be. Here, the poet explains how wild, strong and ferocious the people of the arrowmaker tribe were. They hunted down the enemies in such a way that the dead were strewn for the eagles and vultures to feast upon. They had sharp spears and broad shields crafted with their own hands. To symbolize their expertise, every hut in the tribal village had a sample bow and arrow tied at the entrance. The arrows they made were tipped at their tails with shrunken honeycombs brought down from the tall peaks of the mountains. They knew every nuance and technique of making the finest of bows and arrows. They always had ferocious dogs as their guards for the huts. And these dogs also assisted them in hunting. They often hunted huge mountain monitor lizards. And he describes the lizard's eggs as conch-shaped. The tribe would cook the meat of the monitors and their eggs and serve the guests with much hospitality. After enjoying the hospitality of the huntsmen, we would love to stay over for some more time. But we have a great deal to travel and greater to learn. Catch you in the next part. Thank you.